The continuing debate over police departments and the disputed use of force. Yesterday, the Department of Justice announced it will review the conduct of the San Francisco Police Department. It comes after the fatal shooting of Mario Woods, a 26-year-old African-American man, in December. Police said Woods was brandishing a knife and less lethal methods had failed to stop him. But cell phone video has cast doubt on the police claims. Our colleagues at public station KQED cobbled together two cell phone videos taken of the shooting, first in real time and then slowed down. A warning, this does contain violent gunfire. Hari Sreenivasan has more from New York on the efforts to change police departments and behavior.
In San Francisco's case, the city voluntarily asked the federal government to do the review. But there have been many other investigations and settlements with the federal government that are not undertaken voluntarily. Frontline, along with the Washington Post, have looked at how those have worked in cities like Los Angeles and Detroit. Sarah Childress is a digital reporter for Frontline who's worked on this project, including an in-depth interactive called Fixing the Fourth. She joins us now from Boston. So, Sarah, San Francisco's case is a little abnormal in considering the investigations that you've launched, but because they're doing this of their own accord.
That's right. This is actually a separate process from what the Justice Department calls its pattern or practice investigations, where they investigate a department and then compel them to implement reforms. This is what it's under a separate office in the Justice Department, and it's called their collaborative review process. And they so the Justice Department does conduct an investigation, a review, but then they recommend reforms, and it's up to the departments to decide whether or how to implement them. And that's what's happening in San Francisco. So there'll be no binding agreement and no the Justice Department won't be able to sue the department if they don't actually implement reforms.
Now, we hear about these investigations oftentimes because of a very high-profile abuse of force or something that kind of makes the news. But as you point out, these investigations have been going on for quite some time.
That's right. The Justice Department has been investigating police departments since 1994, when they first got the authority to do so. So there's been about 68 investigations in that time. This collaborative reform process, though, is pretty new. It's only they started it back in 2011. And so there's only been about 7 departments that have gone through this process. And so it's difficult to tell how it works. Actually, only one department, the Las Vegas Metropolitan Police Department, has actually finished the entire reform process under this collaborative review process. So it's difficult to say how effective it'll be.
So given the amount of time and money the Justice Department, along with the local police agencies, are spending, are these plans working?
Well, it's a great question. And it's really hard to say. We spent several months investigating this with the Washington Post, and we found pretty mixed results. In a lot of cases, officers get better training, better equipment, and certainly become more professional. But in terms of actually changing how those officers are policing, whether it's changing, reducing use of force, for example, reducing the amount of time citizens are filing complaints, that was much more difficult to tell. Most of these agreements, when they're court enforced, it's at least a 5-year process. I mean, look, transforming a police department takes a lot of time. It's a lot of money, and it's a lot of effort. So you can't just do these things overnight. And so, you know, I know that, you know, activists, when they talk about reforms, they want to see progress right away. And with these sort of long-term investigations and reform processes, that usually isn't the case.
As you pointed out, this also not just takes time, but it takes money. And a lot of these things don't exactly end exactly at the end of year 2 or year 5. So who foots the bill?
Well, it's up to the cities. They're responsible for paying for all of these reforms. There is a process by which they can apply for grants, and sometimes the Justice Department will provide, you know, technical assistance or other help. But it's really up to the cities And in some cases, you know, these can cost millions, especially with larger departments. You know, if you're implementing new training, new equipment, hiring additional staffing, in the case of Los Angeles, which was one of the longest running reform process over a decade, you know, it cost an estimated $300 million. You know, that's a lot of money.
Are there any metrics that measure outcomes? I mean, is there less abusive force after one of these interventions?
Well, that's a great question, and that's one we actually tried to answer in our investigation with the Washington Post. And we came up with mixed results. In some cases, departments definitely were using less force, officers were better trained, and departments were better able to investigate incidents, officer-involved shootings. But in other cases, the data was really mixed. There isn't a national standard on use of force, and so it's really difficult to compare department to a department, or even within a department, once the Justice Department comes in and starts changing how they report use of force. So the short answer is, it's hard to say. We really don't know yet.
All right, Sarah Childress from Frontline, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.